Okay, let's take another problem on Esker method. Okay, till now we completed problems on converting the unit hydrograph into flood hydrograph and converting the flood hydrograph into unit hydrograph and calculation of volume in some problems and converting the unit hydrograph to different duration unit hydrograph. Okay, now problem on S-curve. Okay, take the problem. Derive the S-curve from the 4-hour unit hydrograph. Derive the S-curve, I have written here also. Derive the S-curve from the 4-hour unit hydrograph given below. Okay, let's take given is in R. Okay, 0. 4, 8, 12, 16, 20, 24, 28, 32, 36, 40, 44, 48, 52, 56. And ordinates 0, 10, 30. 0, 10, 30, 25, 18, 10, 5, 0, 10, 5, 0. Derive S-curve from the 4-hour unit hydrograph. Time is given, ordinate of 4-hour unit hydrograph is given. Okay, these two are given. What I told you while explaining S-curve method, just lag the given ordinates. Please remember these concepts, lag the given ordinates and add. Okay, n times, infinite time, this word is important, continuous rainfall for infinite times. This is what S-curve. So after adding, you will get a curve like this. So this is what S-curve method. Add, lag and add given unit hydrograph n times, infinite times, in order to get the S-curve. Okay. Now, just lag the given 4-hour unit hydrograph. Lag by 4-hour, lag by 8-hour, lag by 12-hour, lag by 16-hour. How many times? N times. Infinite. Nothing but what? Rainfall is continuous for infinite times. Okay. You can stop, let's say for example, 5 to 6. After 5 to 6 column, you can stop. Actually, this is infinite time, but you can stop. You can stop. Okay, now, lag by 4-hour, nothing but start the same unit hydrograph by lagged by 4-hour, nothing but start from 4, 0, okay, 10, 30, 25, okay, next 18, 10, 5, 0, lagged by 4-hour. Next is lagged by 8-hour. Same unit hydrograph, lagged by 8-hour, nothing but start writing the same unit hydrograph by 8-hour. Means corresponding to 8-hour. That is what? 0. Okay, next is 10, 30, 25, 30, 25, 18, 10, 5, 0. Again, lagged by 12-hour. Nothing but start writing the values. Lagged by 12-hour means start from writing 12-hour. Okay. Start writing by 12-hour. So this is what 12-hour. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. Yes. So 0, 10, 30, 25, 30, 25. Okay. 18. 18, then 10, then 5, 0. Lagged by 16 hour. Lagged by 16 hour. 0, 10, 30, 25, 10, 30, 25, 18, 10, 5, 0. Similarly, lag. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 times lag. Nothing but starts from lagged by 20 hour. So this is 4 hour unit graph na. Idna clipatu. So 1 time lag, 2 time lag, 3 time lag, 4 time lag, 5 time lag. Okay. Next 0, 10, 30, 25, 30, 25, okay, 18, 10, 5, 0. Next lag, 0, 10, 30, 25, 25, 18, 10, 5, 0. Again lag. 3, 6, 7 times. Yes. 0, 10, 30, 25, 18, 10, 5, 0. Now, in order to get the S curve, 4 hour S curve, in order to get the 4 hour S curve, just add. First one is 0. Next, second one is 10 plus 0, 0, nothing here. This is 10. Again, next 30, 10, next 0, nothing, 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 nothing. You will get 10 plus 30 plus 10, 40. Next 25, okay, plus 30, 55, plus 10, 65, 0, 65, 65, 65, 65. Next, next one 18 plus 25 plus 30 plus 10. 0, then nothing. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay. Right here. Correspondingly, write all the 40, 65, 83, 93, 98, 98, 98. Just add corresponding values. Means one first value, they are like this similar, yeah, 10 plus 18, 25, like that. Okay, correct add madkon banni, you will get the values like it. Once constant value bantakshana, you can stop. Because this is S curve, right? So once this point is reached, then curve is straight line. Then the S curve is straight line. So next, all the values are constant. Next, definitely, if you try to lag by 32 hour, try to lag by 36 hour, 40 hour, definitely you're going to get 98 only. Definitely you're going to get 98 only. Because after this point, S curve is straight line. Okay, this is the S curve method. Or you can simply write, instead of writing all these things, you can simply write first value 0 or first value 0. Next, for the second place, 10 plus 0. Okay, next value is 10. Okay. Next, for the third place, 30 plus 10 plus 0. So you will get 30 plus 10, 40. Next, for the fourth place, 25 plus 30 plus 10 plus 0. So 25, 30, 55 plus 10, 65. Next, for the fifth place, plus 25 plus 30 plus 10 plus 0. Okay, you will get 25. 55, 65, 75, 85, 83. Correct? 83. Again, if you add for the 6th place, plus 18, plus 25 plus 30 plus 10, you're going to get plus 10. Add agatha, you will get 93. Okay, similarly, you will get next just plus 5. 93 plus 5, 98. Again, 98. Again, 98. Okay, you are getting the same values, correct? Instead of doing all these things, this is a huge procedure, na? Okay, every time we need to lag by 4 hour. Instead of doing all these things, you can do in a simple one-step answer. For the second place, add previous one. For the third place, add all previous ordinates. For the next place, add all previous ordinates. Okay, you will get the same values. Once you getting constant values, you can understand that S-curve becomes straight line. Okay, this is about construction of S-curve from a known unit hydrograph. Yes, let's take down another problem on S-curve only. Take down problem. The ordinate of 4 hour unit hydrograph, ordinate of 4 hour unit hydrograph are given below. Okay, obtain the ordinate of 2 hour unit hydrograph. Obtain the ordinate of 2 hour unit hydrograph, and hence obtain 2 hour storm hydrograph. 2 hour storm hydrograph. If rainfall excess of 25 mm results from a storm. Okay, listen, in this problem the given datas are time and 4 hour unit hydrograph. Okay, time and 4 hour unit hydrograph are given. Okay, and we need to calculate 2 hour unit hydrograph. Okay, we need, given is 4 hour unit hydrograph. Okay, we need to calculate 2 hour unit hydrograph and also flood hydrograph resulting from rainfall excess of result, how much? 25 mm. Okay, 25 mm, it is 2.5 centimeter. So this is the given data. Okay, we need to calculate from this 2 hour unit hydrograph and flood hydrograph. So flood hydrograph results from 2.5 centimeter of excess rainfall. That we can do this problem. 4 hour unit hydrograph is given. Okay, 4 hour unit hydrograph is given. Lag this 4 hour unit hydrograph 4 to 5 times. Okay, so just lag by 4 hours, because 4 hour unit hydrograph is given. 4 hour unit hydrograph is given. So lag by 4 hour. Up to you will get the constant value. Okay, that means S curve after some like this. Just told you in previous problem also. So after this point, S curve will become straight line. Okay, now just lag by 4 hour. From here, lag by 4 hour, 0, 12.5, 62.5, 130, 175, 180, 140, 90, 50, okay, 25, 13, 0. Next, lag by 8 hour. Same unit hydrograph, okay. 0, 12.5, 0, 12.5, 62.5, 130, 175, 180, 140, then 90, 50, 25, 13, 0. Again lagged by 12 hours. Okay, now starts from 12 hour. 0, 12.5, 62.5, 130, 175, 180, 140, 90, 50, 25, 30, 0. Lagged by 16 hour. 16 hour. Okay. 0, okay, 0, 12.5, 62.5, 130, 175, 180, 140, 90, 50, 25, 13, 0. Lagged by 20 hour, 20 hour, 0, 12.5, 62.5, 130, 175, 180, 140, 90, 50, 25, 13, 0. Ordinate of 4 hour S curve. Ordinate of 4 hour S curve. Add all the values. Okay. 0. Next. 12.5, next 62.5, next 130, 140, 142.5. Similarly, add all the values. Okay, I'll write directly. 140, how much this is? 142.5. 142.5, next you will get 237.5, next 322.5, 377.5, 412.5, 427.5, 434.5, 440.5, okay, 440.5, 440.5. Carefully observe, we are getting constant values. Okay, we are getting constant values. So we can stop here. If you continued by lagged by 24 hour after 20, then lag by 28 hour, lag by 32 hour, you will get the same value. You will get the same value. So we can stop 1, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Usually 4 to 6 lag are enough. Okay, you will get S curve. Now this is important. Lag S curve by 2 hour. These are all the unit hydrograph lagged by 4 hour, 8 hour, 12 hour, 16 hour. Unit hydrograph are lagged by 4, 4, 4, 4, 4. Correct. Now this is the sum of the ordinates. You will get the S curve. Now lag the S curve by 2 hour. This is S curve. Lag this S curve by 2 hour, because we need 2 hour unit hydrograph. In the question, they clearly mentioned. Okay, obtain the ordinate of 2 hour unit hydrograph. In the question, they clearly mentioned, obtain the ordinate of 2 hour unit hydrograph. So, lag this S curve by 2 hour. Okay, so this is 2 hour. Start writing from 2 hour. That is lag. See, this S curve only. 0. 12.5, 62.5, 142.5, 237.5, 322.5, 377.5, 412.5, 427.5, 434.5, 440.5, 440.5, and again 440.5. Difference, okay, 0, 12.5, 62.5 minus 12.5 is 50. Similarly, you can do for second one, third one. 12.5 0, 12.5, 50. Okay, and now this is 80, now 95, 85, 55, 35, 15. Okay, next you'll get 7, 6, 0, 0. 12.5, 50, 80, 95, 85, 55, 35, 15, 7, 6, 0, 0. Okay. Now, we need unit hydrograph. We are at the end of the problem. Unit hydrograph. So, this S2 minus S1 divided by, okay, unit hydrograph, nothing but here S2 minus S1 divided by, we need to calculate 2-hour unit hydrograph from 4-hour unit hydrograph. So, 2 divided by 4. Okay. You can, okay. Now, this is 0, we can simplify this one. S2 minus S1, okay, S2 minus S1, S2 minus S1, you can take here 2 by 4, 4 by 2. So, S2 minus S1 into 2, you will get unit hydrograph. Just multiplied by 2, you will get unit hydrograph. 0 into 2, 12.5 into 2, 50 into 2, write for all other values, okay, 0, 25, 100, then 160, then 190, then 170, 110, 70, 30, 14, 12, 0, 0. Okay, and finally, one required is over. In this problem, we have to calculate two things. One is 2-hour unit hydrograph, that is finished. 2-hour unit hydrograph is finished. Now, we need to calculate another thing, flood hydrograph. Okay, this is flood hydrograph. In the very first problem, we know how to calculate flood hydrograph from unit hydrograph. Okay, they are given in the problem rain itself. They are given rainfall excess value. Correct? In the problem itself, they are given rainfall excess value. So, unit hydrograph we have. So, from this unit hydrograph, we can calculate flood hydrograph. So, flood hydrograph is nothing but now 0 into rainfall excess. This is 2-hour unit hydrograph. Unit hydrograph nothing but 1 centimeter depth of excess rainfall. Alva, 2-hour unit hydrograph. Unit hydrograph nothing but 1 centimeter excess rainfall depth. But now I want flood hydrograph of this much rainfall excess, of this much rainfall excess. Now, this 0, that is unit hydrograph, into 2.5. in the first very first problem only we did like this, okay, this very simplest for problem. So this is 0. Now 25 into 2.5, you will get some value. Now 100 into 2.5, you will get some value. 160 into 2.5, okay, write similarly for all other things. Now 0, 62.5, 250, 400, 475, 425, 275, 175. In this problem, we have to calculate two things, 2-hour unit hydrograph and flood hydrograph. So this is 2-hour unit hydrograph, 2-hour unit hydrograph, and this is flood hydrograph of rainfall excess 2.5 centimeter. Okay. Just once I revise you, time is given, 4-hour unit hydrograph is given. Lag the 4-hour unit hydrograph, usually 4 to 6 times until you will get constant value. Lag by 4 hour. This is 4 hour into hydrograph. Lag by 4. Okay. Then add, you will get S ordinate. S curve 4 hour. S curve ordinate. Okay. Then lag this 4 hour S curve ordinate by 2 hour. Because we need to calculate for 2 hours. Just lag by 2 hours, same values lagged by 2 hours. Then take the difference. Okay, this is one S curve, first one. Okay, and next one is second one S curve, lagged by 2 hour. Okay, this is another S curve. Okay, once you subtracted, you will get this region. Okay, so now this region divided by, now we need to calculate unit hydrograph. Unit hydrograph nothing but difference value divided by 2 by 4. 2 over unit hydrograph divided by 4 over unit hydrograph. So you will get simplification, after simplification you get 2. So multiply this ordinates by 2. You will get unit hydrograph. Once you get the unit hydrograph, convert that unit hydrograph into flood hydrograph. Flood hydrograph of rainfall excess 2.5 centimeter. Unit hydrograph of rainfall excess 1 centimeter depth. Flood hydrograph of rainfall excess 2.5 centimeter. Okay. This completes module 3. Thank you.